Okay, so for time varying fields, right, the Maxwell's equations, the first two Maxwell's equations, right, doesn't vary, right? Those two things are, right, one is del cross, one is, right, del dot d bar is equal to rho v. This doesn't change because the divergence is not changing. The Gauss law holds also good, right? First equation. Second equation is, because the magnetic field is always closed, so del dot b bar is equal to zero. This also doesn't change for the time varying fields. Okay, for the time varying fields also we don't have a change of this thing. Okay, del dot b bar is equal to zero, right? So these two equations from the static fields does not change or does not, right, vary. Okay, whereas, right, the other two equations will vary. Okay, so the third equation, this equation is derived from, right, Faraday's law. So what is Faraday's law? Faraday's law is given by E is equal to minus N d phi by dt. Okay, so where E is the EMF, right, N is the number of turns, right, and phi is the flux. Okay, so if N is equal to 1, if I assume N is equal to 1, then E is equal to minus d phi by dt. Now what is E here? E is basically EMF. Okay, as per Faraday, E is basically EMF. Okay, which is nothing but potential, right? Now we know that the potential can be given as, right, so if I know right, so if I know potential, right, so the expression for potential can be given as V is equal to integral E bar dot dl bar, right? V is equal to minus integral E bar dot dl bar. So substituting that here, right, what I get, E is equal to, right, V is equal to, so that is small e is nothing but V. So therefore I can write this as, right, E bar dot dl bar, okay, is equal to minus d phi by dt, correct? Okay, so the expression is like this, right? Now understood till this point, ma? So E is nothing but EMF. EMF is nothing but potential. Now potential can be given as, right, V is equal to minus integral, right, E bar dot dl bar. Now what is phi? Phi is basically flux, right? So, right, flux can be given as, in terms of flux density, we can write flux as phi is equal to, right, integral, right, the magnetic flux density, right, it is magnetic flux density, so we write it as B bar dot ds, correct? Phi is equal to integral B bar dot ds. So therefore, now substituting that phi here, okay, what I get, minus integral E dot E bar dot dl bar is equal to, right, minus d by dt of integral, right, B bar dot ds. Okay, so, right, instead of E, I have written the expression for potential, and phi is flux. So flux can be given in terms of flux density as, right, phi is the total flux, B bar is the flux density. So flux density, if I integrate over the surface, I will get the flux, right, total flux. So therefore I am writing like this. Now, so this is equal to, right, so changing the order of integration and differentiation. So let us send this thing into inside. So what I get is integral, right, put the cancel out the minus signs, right, take off them. Okay, so what I get, integral. So now it will become partial derivative because we have changed. So dou b bar into ds, correct? Okay, so integral E bar dot dl is equal to, right, integral of this. Okay, now right, clear till this point, right? Now now as per the Stokes theorem, so first write down what it is. E bar dot dl bar is equal to minus, sorry, minus is not there, integral dou b by dou t ds. Okay, now as per the Stokes theorem, right, the closed integral E bar dot dl bar can be written in terms of surface integral. Okay, so closed surface, right, in terms of surface integral as del cross E dot ds, right, as per Stokes theorem. Line integral can be converted into surface integral, right, in this form. Okay, so the line integral of vector can be written as curl of surface integral of the curl of the vector. Okay, so we'll write del cross E ds. So therefore, this expression, what does this expression will become? Del cross E into ds is equal to, right, integral dou B by dou T ds. So on both sides we have ds, so we can equate the remaining terms, right? So del cross E is equal to, right, okay, dou B by dou T. So this, right, okay, this is the Maxwell's equation for right, for a time varying field. Okay, if the B, that is if the if in the coil, right, we are taking the coil where the EMF is produced, where the electric field is produced, correct? If the electric field, or okay, the coil, right, the magnetic field that is linked to the coil, if it is constant with the time, okay, if it is static in nature, right? So if the magnetic field is static in nature, that is if it does not vary with the time, then dou B by dou T will be zero, correct? So then what we get, del cross E is equal to zero, correct? Okay, so this will be the Maxwell equation for static fields. Understood? So correct. So if the magnetic field, because the magnetic field is varying in nature, this equation is changed like this: del cross E is equal to dou B by dou T. Otherwise, if the magnetic field is static, then dou B by dou T, that means static means it is constant with time. So if it is constant with time, dou B by dou T will be, right, zero. So that means del cross E is equal to zero, which will be the previous equation. Okay, so this is about the third equation that is derived from Faraday's law, right? Next, let us go to the last equation, the fourth equation. The fourth equation that is derived from from Ampere's law, right? Okay, so the fourth Maxwell's equation derived from Ampere's law, or we call it as inconsistency of Ampere's law. Very important for exam, right? Okay, in most of the cases, right, we are asked this question. Okay, what is inconsistency of Ampere's law? Derive the Maxwell's equation from that. Okay, yeah. So firstly, what is Ampere's law? Ampere's law states that, right, when I take a closed Amperean path, right, when I take a closed Amperean path around a conductor, right, and calculate the H bar in this closed path, then the H bar dot DL bar, that is the closed of this, will be equal to the current enclosed in the path, correct? Current passing through the conductor. Okay, so H dot DL is equal to I. This is what Ampere's law is, correct? Okay, this is the Ampere's law. Okay, so we have slightly modified, right, from this, right, we got closed line integral can be converted into, that is, I can be written as J dot DS, right, in terms of current density. Okay, this is written H dot DL. Okay, then again using Stokes theorem, we converted line integral into surface integral, so which we have written del cross H, right, into DS is equal to J dot DS, correct? Okay, so when we are calculating the curl, we have found like this, right? So we have expressed del cross H is equal to J. Okay, del cross H is equal to J. That's what we got, correct? Okay, so H dot DL is equal to I. I is nothing but total current, which can be written in terms of current density, J, as like this. Okay, so using Stokes theorem, we can write del cross H DS is equal to I DS, J DS, del cross H is equal to J. Okay, right. Now, yeah. Now, take this equation, del cross H is equal to J, right? Take the equation, del cross H is equal to J. Okay, apply divergence on both sides. Okay, take divergence on both sides. That is, del dot del cross H is equal to del dot J. Okay, del dot del cross H is equal to del dot J. Okay, correct. Now, from the continuity equation, we derived something called as continuity equation, if I remember. Okay, So del dot j, what is continuity equation? Del dot j is equal to minus dou rho v by dou t. Okay, if you remember clearly, del dot j is equal to minus dou rho v by dou t. Okay, so del dot del cross h is equal to, right, minus dou rho v by dou t. Okay, now we have one very important identity in vector, that is divergence of a curl of function, of any function, is always equal to zero. Okay, del dot del cross A is always equal to zero. Okay, so del dot del cross of any vector is always equal to zero. So that means H bar is also a vector, so divergence of the curl is always equal to zero. So this value is always equal to zero. That means minus dou rho v by dou t is equal to zero, correct? Minus dou rho v by dou t is always equal to zero. So, right, that means, right, rho v should be constant. Rho v should be constant with the time. Okay, rho v should be constant with the time. That's what dou rho v by dou t. Okay, when will it become zero? Two cases. When rho v is zero, obviously you'll get zero. Otherwise, what should happen? Right, rho v. Okay, otherwise what should happen? The rho v should be constant with the time. If it is constant with the time, then also dou rho v by dou t is zero. Correct? So, okay. But because we are discussing about the time varying fields, right, the volume charge density, the electrostatic field that you develop is not constant with time, so it is varying. So rho v is variable of time. Okay, right? Okay, the electric field that you produce now is a variable of time varying fields, kada, that's what we are discussing, correct? So rho v is varying with time. That means dou rho v by dou t will not be zero. Okay, dou rho v by dou t will not be zero, right? But whereas from Ampere's law, what we are getting dou rho v by dou t as zero. Okay, dou rho v by dou t as zero. This should hold good, right? So if I apply divergence of a curl, then curl of the magnetic field, then I should get zero, right? But I am not getting zero because rho v is not variable, is not constant with the time. So Ampere's law is not holding good for time varying fields. Okay, so for static fields this will become zero, so the equation gets satisfied. Okay, on LHS I got zero, on RHS also I should get zero, right? So okay, if rho v is constant, if rho v is constant of time, that is static in nature, then dou rho v by dou t is always zero, so no problem at all. But for time varying fields, dou rho v by dou t is not constant, right? It is changing with time. So it is not zero. It is some value. So if it is some value, or if it is some numerical value which is not equal to zero, then this doesn't hold good, right? So this is called as inconsistency of Ampere's law, right? So as rho v is, right, volume charge density varies with the time. If rho v varies with the time, then the Ampere's law does not hold good for those kind of cases, right, which is called as inconsistency of the Ampere's law, right? Therefore Ampere's law is not applicable at all cases of fields, or in all fields, okay, in all types of fields. For time varying fields, right, the Ampere's law fails, correct? Understood, ma? Right? So del cross H is equal to J, right? This is what we have got from Ampere's law, right? Now del cross H, taking the divergence, applying divergence, del dot del cross H is equal to del dot J, correct? Now del dot del cross H, right, of any vector is always zero, okay? So on this side I get zero. Now from continuity equation, del dot J is always equal to rho v. Yeah, one second. Del dot J is equal to rho v, right? So, right, del dot J is equal to minus dou rho v by dou t. That means this should also be zero. When it will be zero? When only rho v is constant with time. If it is not constant with time, this equation doesn't satisfy. Therefore, right, Ampere's law does not hold good for right? Time varying fields. Okay. In order to make Ampere's law applicable to time varying fields, what Maxwell has done is he has added one more term to the equation of Ampere's law, that is del cross H is equal to, we have added a new term called as N. Okay. Del cross H is equal to J plus N. Okay. Del cross H is equal to J plus N. Right. So a new term N is added, and let us derive what is the value of N from which we get our last Maxwell's equation. Okay. Understood, ma? So Ampere's law, the del cross H is equal to J doesn't hold good for time varying fields because rho V is not constant with the time. So to modify that, Maxwell has added another term called as N to the original equation. So therefore, now the equation of Ampere's is written as del cross H is equal to J plus N. So what is this N? Let us derive. Okay. Now, same, apply divergence on both sides. What we get, del cross del dot del cross H is equal to del dot J plus del dot N. Correct? Okay. Just now we discussed that this value is always zero. So, right, equating it to zero, zero is equal to del dot J plus del dot N. Okay. That means del dot N is equal to minus del dot J. Correct? Del dot N is equal to minus del dot J. Okay. Now, right? Now, del dot J, from the continuity equation, we got del dot J is equal to minus del dot dou B by dou T. Correct? Dou D bar. What is that? Dou rho V by dou T. All right? Dou rho V by dou T. Okay? So, del is equal to minus dou rho V by dou T. Okay? Now, interchanging this term and this term. Okay? Let us interchange. Just a second, I lost it. Okay, right. So del dot N is equal to minus del dot J. Minus del dot J is nothing but dou rho V by dou T. So minus dou rho V by dou T, minus minus gets cancelled. This total term becomes dou rho V by dou T. Clear? Correct? Yeah. Del dot N is equal to dou rho V by dou T. Okay. Now, the same thing, this thing can be, right? Rho V, what is rho V? Volume charge density, right? So, from the first Maxwell's equation, we can write del dot D bar is equal to rho V, correct? So, we have a Maxwell's equation which is nothing but del dot D bar is equal to rho V. So, writing that here, dou by dou T of, instead of rho V, what we write is del dot D bar, okay? Del dot D bar, okay? So, interchange the del operator and the differential operator with each other. So, what we get is del dot, right, dou D bar by dou T. Okay, so exchanging the del, and del is differential operator with space, D by X, dou by dou X, dou by dou Y, dou by dou Z. Okay, this is dou by dou T. So we are exchanging the differentials. Okay, right, order of differentials. So what I get is del dot N is equal to, right, del dot dou D bar by dou T. Okay, yeah, just a second, just verify it again. Del cross H is equal to, now J plus a new term N is added. Okay. Del cross, del, taking the divergence on both sides, del dot del cross H is equal to del dot J plus del dot N. Right. Now this is always equal to zero. So, right, del dot J plus del dot N is equal to zero, or del dot N is equal to minus del dot J. Then it will become zero. Correct. Okay. Yeah. So, del dot N is equal to, what is del dot J? Dou rho V by dou T. Okay, dou rho V by dou T. Right, as per continuity equation. Now again, rho V, from the first Maxwell's equation, rho V is equal to, right, del dot D bar. Okay, right, rho V is equal to del dot D bar. So, if I write, right, del dot D bar. Okay, so exchanging del operator and, this bar, so we will get this thing. So therefore, equating on both sides, I have got del dot this and del dot this. So same del operator, we can equate these two terms. So therefore, N is equal to, N can be written as dou D bar by dou T. Okay. So what we get is N is equal to dou D bar by dou T. So substituting that here, right, what we get is del cross H bar is equal to, right, J plus dou D bar by dou T. So this is the last Maxwell's equation. Okay. So the final, the fourth Maxwell's equation that is derived from Ampere's law, which can be written as del cross H bar is equal to J plus dou D bar by dou T. This term, dou D bar by dou T, generally del cross H represents, right, current density. So this is, right, here there are two types of current densities now. Okay. One is J. So J, instead of J, what we write is JC, right? So this J, we treat it as JC. What is JC? JC indicates, right? JC indicates the, JC indicates the, right, conduction current density. Okay. So conduction current density, that means current density due to conductors. Okay. Whereas this term dou D bar by dou T, it is represented by JD, right? JD, which is called as displacement current density, right? Or convection current density. Okay. So, right, we get two terms on the RHS side. The first term J, right, we call it as, right, conduction current density or current density due to, right, drift current. Dou D bar by dou T also is a form of, current density, and that current density we call it as, right, displacement current density or convection current density. Okay. So this is the fourth Maxwell's equation, right, which we get like this. Okay. Clear with this, right? So these are the four Maxwell's equations for time varying fields. Ma, the first two equations remain as it is. Del dot D bar is equal to rho V. Del dot B bar is equal to zero. Those two does not change. Okay. The other two get changed. So del cross E is equal to zero becomes del cross E is equal to, right, what we got, dou B bar by dou T. Okay. And the other term that the other we have got, del cross H is equal to J. Now it has become del cross H is equal to J plus dou D by dou T. Okay. So from this, right, Maxwell has again used these equations, right, and developed wave equations. Okay. So that we will study in the next unit. Okay. Right. So this is all about the Maxwell's equations for time varying fields. Okay. I hope this concept.